Salutations, celestial sightseers. I am David Fuller with Eyes on the Sky. There is not a lot that I get asked to necessarily recommend, and the things that I have been asked to recommend, I have sometimes looked at and thought, I don't want to recommend that to my followers because it doesn't look like a very good product. However, I was asked recently to recommend something, and I wholeheartedly leaped at the chance and said, yes, absolutely, I will. And that is to recommend to you this particular book. Actually, I wasn't even asked to recommend it, I just asked to review it, but I would wholeheartedly recommend it as well because this book, the precursor to it, is what got me started in amateur astronomy and helped me to understand the night sky, understand telescopes, eyepieces, binoculars, how to navigate the night sky, how to get started in photography, which I want to show you. I still have my single lens reflex film camera that I first used for astrophotography. Took horrible photos, but nevertheless, that was my fault just because I didn't know what I was doing and didn't have anyone to really help me at the time. And I still have that original book. This is a revised version of the original one. I think they had done a couple small revisions after it was first published in 91. I bought this sometime in the mid-90s. They've done a couple short revisions, probably for spelling errors and a couple updated things for eyepieces and things like that. For the most part, it was still the original version. And I have referenced this book numerous times over the years because it's helped me, because there are still things in there that were useful to know. And there were certain things that certainly got out of date, like eyepieces and film photography and whatever else, but there's still things in there that survived to this version. Now, the cool thing about this version, which I have looked at and reviewed myself, is they've revised how they've set up the book, which I think is really helpful for anyone who's getting started because, and we'll just kind of go through a little bit of what they've done with the table of contents and how they've organized the book. They've talked about naked eye, your observing sight, getting to know the sky better, buying binoculars for astronomy, which are incredibly important. I've talked about that a number of times over the years. Then they do binocular sky tours. So things that you can find and see, like some of the stuff that we've done over the years, choosing a telescope, choosing eyepieces and filters, accessories that are ones that are essential to have, nice to have, luxury items, using your new telescope, how to use it. We've talked about some of that with some of the telescope basics videos that I've done years ago, using your go-to telescope. Now that's really cool because they talk about Meade, Celestron, and the Orion Skywatcher line of products. And they give a little bit of an overview of each one of those. And then they talk about observing things like the sun, moon, eclipses, because we've got another eclipse in the United States coming up in 2024. Then they do moon tours, which was not even in the original version. So they talk about what kinds of things you should look for and how to observe them. And then the solar system, deep sky, telescope sky tours, much like I have done. And that book was so much of what helped me understand what I needed to know in order to help you be able to find things in the night sky. And I've got a whole bookcase full of books on astronomy, but this one was the one that really got me started with all of that. So if you, or if someone you know, whether this be something for Christmas or birthday or other holiday, or just a gift you want to give someone who's interested in astronomy, or if you want it for yourself, that's totally okay too. This book I cannot recommend highly enough. Absolutely, The Backyard Astronomer's Guide, fourth edition by Terence Dickinson and Alan Dyer. I wholeheartedly recommend getting this book because it will be a book that can be referenced for years to come and will be a useful reference tool that will just not go out of style for certain segments of it with respect to observing and some of the tours and things like that. Of course, equipment always changes, but as far as a reference for some of those other things, you're always going to be able to use this book. It's definitely a worthwhile investment in your astronomy observing and potentially astrophotography if you want to do that too. So give it a look and think about it seriously. This guy says thumbs up all the way. Thanks for watching, and I hope you will, if you like this video, please subscribe, hit the like also as well, and I will have a lot more content coming up in the weeks and months to come. Thanks so much. Clear and dark skies.